So here we are, and I'm faced with a classic feature on my peg here today. Got an island probably about 20, 22 meters away, something like that, not very far at all. Obviously, you know, on a lot of fisheries that you go to, you can be faced with these sort of features that you might want to cast your feeder to. And for me, the instinct was always to go for the method feeder. And a lot of people are saying, well, why the pellet feeder? When change, what to look for? So that's what I want to run you through today, because really I've got not a lot of bait with me, but I've got a really simple setup, and I'm going to have a great day's fishing here today by just making sure I keep on top of things while I'm actually fishing. So first of all, I'm going to look at the setup. I've got a 9-foot rod. Okay, this is the Monster X Carp feeder, and this is the sort of rod I'm looking for this commercial work. I'm not casting very far, and shorter rods are definitely an advantage to helping me maintain accuracy. I really do love a 9-foot rod for anything under about 25 meters on a commercial. They really are a great tool. The 10-foot is there in case your fish are a bit bigger, or if you're going to be casting that little bit further. For me, I would then step up to the 10-foot. On my Centris reel, I've got 8-pound sinking feeder mono. Now, that may seem a little bit excessive to some people. Some people may think that's the obvious choice. The reason I've gone with 8-pound is I want absolute durability, and I'm not casting very far. I don't need a thin main line to obviously help with my cast. So to do that, I can use a thick main line that's really robust. I can cast nice and firmly at the island and have no worries all day. So running down the setup, it couldn't be simpler. I've got a free running ICS stem. So easy to use. I've literally just threaded it on the line, and I've brought the rod all set up here today, and I've got a quick change bead at the bottom. On the venue that I'm fishing here today, I'm allowed to use a free running setup, not allowed to use a fixed setup. And to be honest, when I'm fishing with shorter rods like 9-foot and 10-foot, the rods are so forgiving that I don't see the need to use elasticated setups. I'm quite happy using the safer free running setup. This gives me the option to then turn to either the method feeder or the pellet feeder. And that's where I need to do a little bit of thinking. So first of all, why the method and why the pellet feeder? Now, in my head, it's quite straightforward. I like to use the method feeder to actually feed the peg, to feed the fish while I'm fishing. So often I will make a start on the method feeder. I can then load this up. When I cast in, I'm expecting the bait on the method feeder to break down really quickly. So within a minute, something like that, the bait will be broken down off the feeder, and it generates a lot of food in the peg. And as a result, it draws a lot of fish in. And quite often, and we've all had it, you go in and you catch a few early fish on a method feeder, and it's pretty easy. So you'll go in, you'll be casting in, you're building the peg all the time, and the fish start to come in more numbers. Of course, as you start to catch those fish, they get a bit warier, the numbers thin out a bit. And what happens is you're left with a lot of bait in your peg and not so many fish, which makes the fish harder to catch. That's when I'm looking to change to a pellet feeder. Now, with a pellet feeder, I'm actually going to wedge the bait into the pellet feeder, and the pellet feeder provides perfect protection for my bait. So the fish actually can't get at the bait in the feeder. They can only get to the hook bait, which is on the edge of the feeder. And what that means is I'm effectively starving them onto the hook. I'm casting in, the fish are coming in, trying to compete at the feeder, and all that's there is my hook bait. So instead of all this and no proper bites, I'm going to get proper rod wrenches as the fish only get to my hook bait. Of course, this may last 5, 6, 7 fish, and then I'm going to have to start to introduce feed again via the method feeder. It's no different to any other form of fishing. Controlling your feed is the key to success, and that is what the pellet feeder allows me to do. And it turns maybe 10, 12 fish in a session into 20 or more. And that's why by rotating between the two, I can obviously get that right.